just very briefly, as you probably know, I speak on energy for UKIP. We have a very exciting energy situation blowing up in the UK. Because of European energy policy, we have a kind of double whammy where we have very high prices which are undermining competitiveness in our industry and are also impacting very severely on households. But at the same time, because we have this over-reliance on intermittent and unpredictable renewables, we also have a very serious supply threat. And this is not just my opinion. This is the government's own energy regulator is saying there's a real risk of blackouts over the next 2 or 3 years. The news yesterday was that the government has reached agreement with EDF to build a new nuclear power station at Hinkley Point. Thank you to the French and to our General Secretary for providing the expertise. As Brits, we are thoroughly ashamed of the fact that having led the development of nuclear power for peaceful purposes, we now find ourselves in 2013 in a situation where we are simply unable by ourselves to build a nuclear power station. But never mind, we have to go to the French for the expertise, we have to go to the Chinese for the money, and we are now in a situation where, thank heaven, we appear to have a commitment to build a new nuclear power station, although there is still a big issue about how much it's going to cost, because the deal the government has made with EDF involves paying them over the odds for energy for a period of 35 years. I thought it was an interesting development, because these same problems of high energy prices and the threat to supplies are reflected, I think, in many European countries as a result of European energy policy. There is a longer debate to be had about how we should finance nuclear power stations, given the very large amounts of money, the very long time horizons, and also the huge degree of regulatory uncertainty, with the rules changing almost monthly and Angela Merkel closing down the German nuclear fleet. It obviously creates huge problems for people who propose to invest in nuclear energy. I just thought colleagues might be interested to know how this development is playing out in the UK. Thank you very much.